Good afternoon, middle school. I'm Liam Mesages.
And I'm Jacob Kim. Today we're going to show you some fun videos, announcements, and some current events.
Okay, first let's listen to the announcements.
I hope you all went to the 7th grade mall because it was awesome and it turned out really well.
And the Thanksgiving lunch was awesome. Check it out.
Not feeling you.
I hope you all liked it.
For the 6th grade field trip to Rincón de la Vieja National Park, the permission slips, medical forms, and the payments are due tomorrow.
After listening to all this, let's have a break and check out the pictures of the Halloween party.
My eyes beheld an eerie sight, for my monster from his slab began to rise, and suddenly, to my surprise...
So we are here with Nicole and Becca. So, Nicole and Becca, can you tell me the costumes you wore to the dance?
I was a skeleton. I was a fairy.
Which fairy?
A pink fairy.
Oh, okay.
Pink fairy.
So, did you like the dance?
Yeah, it was really fun. It was good.
Will you change something about the dance?
Well, I would make all the kids in our grade dance because no one did.
Yeah, there should be more people there.
Mm-hmm. Maybe a bigger space because it was really hot in there.
I agree.
And Nicole, since you lived in the States before and you're new to this school, you had dances in the States before?
Yeah, they were a lot different from the Seville. The ones I've been to, there's a lot more people there. But I like this one, it's fun.
We are with Gabriela Zabaley.
So, Gabi, what are your opinions about the dance?
I think that it could have been more entertaining. They have something that...
It was a great dance! I think it was a great dance!
Yeah, it was a great dance. It was a great dance.
But
it could have been more entertaining.
Entertaining? What else do you want?
Like, more like, I don't know, more like neon.
Neon?
Yeah.
We had fog and we had lights. What's neon?
Like, in the school, he says, neon.
Oh, the bracelets and the.
On Saturday, I went to another display and they had like neon.
Okay, fine, I'll get you neon for next year.
Yeah, neon.
Neon.
So, did you go to the dance last year?
Yes.
So which one did you like better? This one or the last one?
The last one.
Why?
I don't know. The last one had more things to
entertainment,
do.
As you just said.
Yeah. More entertainment.
This mash was meant to. When you get to my door, tell them what is said.
Then you can mash.
Then you can monster mash.
The monster mash.
And do my graveyard smash.
Then you can mash.
You'll catch on in a flash.
Then you can mash.
Then you can monster mash.
Good choice for the winner.
This just in, the 5th and 6th grade girls soccer team that won their final game against Blue Valley. Congrats, ladies.
An upcoming game for middle school girls is tomorrow, Wednesday, November 28th. Girls soccer team against Lighthouse. The game will be at home.
And middle school boys play Thursday, November 29th against ICS at ICS.
Recently, the 6th grade visited La Tica, and now we will show you the footage from the trip.
And right after that, we will see some reactions to the USA 2012 elections.
do a little something called editing. We cut away the pieces that we can't use.
So Mikael, what do you think about the result of the election? Are you happy?
I wasn't really happy because I didn't think like Florida didn't have a chance to actually put their votes in, and I thought Mitt Romney would have won Florida, which would have given him a possibility of winning the elections. But since Florida didn't get in, and other states also didn't get in, we didn't win. And also, nope. Republican president has ever won without Ohio, and it was sad that we lost Ohio.
What went through your mind during the election?
Well, I was really hoping that Obama wouldn't be elected as president again, because the past 4 years, he's not done a good job with the economy. The unemployment rate has been worse, like one in the worst of all time in the United States, and many people would blame this on President Bush, but I also would blame it a little bit on Obama because he said he was changed and that he was going to provide success for the economy. Well, he hasn't done very much. In fact, he's made the economy even worse.
Do you think 4 years is enough to change the country or not?
I don't think it's enough, but it could be a start. And if Mitt Romney would have been elected president, he would have created 12 million new jobs, which would have helped the economy. And he's also got business management skills, which would have helped the economy grow and be successful.
Thank you very much. Lieutenant, how do you feel about the elections?
I feel pretty good about the elections. I know it's very controversial. I know that some people in the U.S. are really upset about certain policies and they were hoping for changes, but I personally think the policies are pretty solid. And I look forward to seeing 4 more years to implement those policies. I think it's going to be good.
What went through your mind during the election?
Well, actually, I thought Obama was going to lose this time. I was a little bit surprised to see that he won, even though it wasn't by much. Maybe because some of my family in the United States are very conservative Republicans, and I am not. So I guess after hearing their opinions about a lot of things, I thought Obama was going to lose, but turned out they were wrong.
Did you watch the
debate? No. You know that I have not had a television in my house for 18 years, and so I miss some things. Like, I try to go online and watch things that I'm really interested in, but if I'm tired, I just miss them. So I was sorry that I missed the debates.
So do you think 4 years is enough to make a change?
Well, I see changes already in the immigration policies that I think are very positive. I see changes in the health policies, which I think are positive. We'll have to see what else happens.
Okay, thank you very much, Dr. Nguyen.
And it's on.
So, Mr. Chan.
Oscar, reporting here. Mr. Chanding with Julian. And the awesome Havasi. Let's talk about the elections. Gentlemen,
so
what are your thoughts?
Were you satisfied by the result of the election?
In what sense? Satisfied? Like happy?
Yeah.
Pleased? It's difficult. The U.S., because of its two-party political system, makes it very, very challenging to pass things through. I actually prefer parliamentary elections over Republican elections. Does that make sense? The Canadian or the English system, in which the biggest party kind of, you have to have a coalition of parties, and then the prime minister is elected through the party that got the most votes. So, I mean, not really. No, I'm not very satisfied, though.
What went through your mind during the elections?
During the elections, I wrestle a lot with whether the U.S. is a country that thinks of itself as a unified whole, and whether people are voting for the common good. You know, what is good for everybody?
It's become, in my opinion, elections become a little bit more like turf gang warfare, where, you know, our party believes this. Now, whether what we believe is good or not is not examined. It's just whether we believe this and therefore it happens. And then there's a sort of demonizing of the other. That sort of really nasty gang warfare is not helpful. So it's not helpful for the good of all. It's not helpful for the sense that we're all in this together. And so I have this real sense of what we call polarization, political polarization, demonization of the other. And it's nasty. To the nasty finger pointing and the bickering. It's really hard, you guys. It's really hard. So no, I don't think 4 years, if nothing has changed, will really change very much. I'm afraid. I hope so. Now, having said that, we do have elections in 2 more years. Because remember, the Democrats have a majority in the Senate, right? It's not a very big majority, but it's a small majority. And then they only need a few more congresspeople. So in 2 years, just congressional elections, and those will matter a lot. Anything else?
Thank you, Mr. Tim.
We hope that the Olympics are going well with all the grades, and we look forward to seeing your creations on December 12th through 13th.
Good afternoon, and see you in the next broadcast.
We leave you all with this final video.